Hello mathematicians, you are welcome to my YouTube channel. This is eMaths, and without wasting much of our time, we'll be going straight to indices, because this is one of the fundamental topics that you need to know when you enter the senior secondary school. Okay, so indices, what's the introduction to this? So if a positive variable is multiplied by itself four times, that is, let's say the variable is A. Now when you multiply A by itself four times, it becomes A times A times A. Then it can be written as A raised to the power of 4. So how do you pronounce this? A raised to the power of 4, as simple as that. This is it. Now when you multiply A times A times A times A, you get A into 4 places, that is A raised to the power of 4. And any expression written as a raised to power n is defined as the variable a raised to the power of n. Let me take that again. Any expression written as a as the base and n as the power is defined as the variable a, which is the variable a raised to the power of n, which is the power, where a is the base and n is the power, index or exponent. So when you have something a raised to n, the a here is called the base and the n is called the power, the index or the exponent. I hope you understand this. So you're just going to go straight to some of the laws. And you might be wondering, how did I even arrive at a raised to the power of 4? So this is going to be given in the laws, when I start treating the laws, because there are various laws of indices, but they are not difficult. So you just need to pay close attention as I go straight to the laws of indices. So these are the laws of indices. The first one I'll be treating is the multiplication law. When numbers with equal bases are being multiplied, their powers, which is their indices, are added together. Let's take that again. When numbers with equal bases, for instance, if you have A times A times A times A, so you have it like this. Now, the power is actually invisible because it has the power of 1. It is not indicated there. So in other words, you can rewrite this as A raised to power 1 times A raised to power 1 times A raised to power 1 times A raised to power 1. Now, when you have this, it means that they have the same base. So, this is the multiplication law, that you are going to add the powers together. You are going to bring the powers together. You take one of the base, you bring the power of the first one, a raised to power 1. You add the second one, a raised to power 1. You add the third one, a raised to power 1. And you add the last one, which is plus 1. Now, when you have this, you have 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1. That is, I have a raised to the power of 4. That is about multiplication law. Now, when you have, in general, let's say you have a raised to power m times a raised to power n. This is how you do it. They have the same base, which is similar bases. So it becomes a raised to power m plus n. So let's take this as the general form for the multiplication law of indices. Okay, let's quickly solve some examples on this multiplication law. Now we have 3 raised to power 2 times 3 raised to power 5. So don't forget that multiplication law says that when you have the same bases, you are going to add your powers together. So for this, now you have 3 raised to the power of 2 here, and times 3 raised to the power of 5 becomes 3 raised to the power 2 plus 5. It becomes 3 raised to power 2 plus 5 gives you 7. That is it for that. Now if you have another, let's say you have a raised to the power x times a raised to the power x plus 1. So it now becomes a, since they have the similar base, which is a and a, you bring one of the base, then you add their powers together. So it becomes x plus 1. So this x is this and x plus 1 is this. So you add this addition sign. It becomes a raised to power x plus x gives you 2x plus 1. So this is it. Alright, the third question I'll be doing, which is the last question for the multiplication law. If you have 4 raised to the power 2 plus, I'm sorry, multiply by 4 raised to the power 6 multiply by 4 raised to the power 3. So it becomes, since they have the similar base, you have 4. So you have 4 raised to the power 2 plus 6, which is the 6, plus 3. So it becomes 4 raised to the power 2 plus 6 gives you 8. 8 plus 3 gives you 11. So you have 4 raised to the power 11. Now let me quickly solve one that doesn't have the same base. When you have x raised to the power 2 multiplied by y raised to the power 2 multiplied by x raised to the power 3. Now, bringing this together, you have x raised to the power 2. So you collect your like terms. You bring the one that is similar together. So x raised to the power 2 multiplied by x raised to the power 3 multiplied by y raised to the power 2. So this and this have the similar base, which is x and x, but y is different. So you add the base of this together. You have x raised to the power 2 plus 3 times y raised to the power 2. So it becomes x raised to the power 5 times y raised to the power 2. So it gives you x raised to the power 5, y raised to the power 2. So I hope this video was actually helpful. So I'll be treating the other laws in the next video. Thank you.